Hello and welcome to a new video. Today we're going to take a look at a more serious team again, which are going to get you a lot of wins. And today I wanted to take a look at Shadow Granville, because I had a lot of times recently where I went up against a thing and it completely destroyed me, because Shadow Granville does not care about typings. This thing is just like, unless you have like, I don't know, a poison jab user or something against you, this thing just goes through everything and just doesn't care. We have like insane games here where we just win against steel types and everything. Even like if you have a dark poison type, which are a lot in the meta right now, like they just cannot do anything. Here we have a Victini against us, which is hilarious. I see a lot of times my Victini team recently, which is cool. Like I always like to see my team get a use, and I had a lot of people running my Victini team recently, which is really cool to see. Always really appreciate that. And here we have the Urshka, which goes for a mud pump. You see how much damage I do with Granville. Also, you can just gonna surrender. We had two shields there, like nothing really I can do. Mandibuzz against us. Most of the time against Mandibuzz, I try to catch on my own Mandibuzz because my Mandibuzz runs Air Slash. Usually, I don't really like to use Air Slash. In this case, I think it's better. And we have the Granville in the back, which is even a better answer to Mandibuzz. Here we get countered by a Manmiddle. Manmiddle basically destroys the whole team, but I don't know. Usually you don't see that as often, but this thing, it goes like through everything here. But we can go for I think he doesn't shield this, luckily. Yeah, I think he didn't know that we were really wicked to that in the back. And here we have a Machamp against us. And we have a Mandibuzz against us as well still. And this game is over because we have Granville, and Granville just does not care. This thing is just insane. Like, we can just go through everything. We don't even have to throw any charge move, and my opponent just surrenders here. Good game there. Bye-bye. Next up, we have Kempoyan against Bronzong. Good matchup for us. Usually I want to catch, but I think I was an idiot here, and I mean, it doesn't really matter anyway. I think he shields? Yeah, he shields anyway, so if we also use a shield for the potential bulldoze, it's fine in my opinion. I wanted to catch, but I was too bad for that. My opponent stops out into Mandibuzz, and we have a Granbull. Nice! Yeah, easy farm down here. Nothing really that is too crazy. And we can just, we survive actually with like some HP there. Usually you can even take two of the area aces from the Mandibuzz, I think, unless it's like attack rated Mandibuzz like mine. And we have a Clefable against us, and we still have our Empoleon with a lot of energy, and this game is over because there's nothing really you can do anymore. We still have our Mandibuzz against the Bronzong, and like if he wants to farm me down here, fun, and he's gonna surrender there because there was nothing he could do. And next we have Nidoqueen, and that's why I really enjoy the Empoleon deed right now. Like against Nidoqueen, it's like so good. Yeah, actually I think shield against the second area ace. Yeah, I had to actually. If I look at my health, I think I wouldn't have survived another Snarl. I kind of wanted to KO that thing at least, and I can go for a Crunch now, which does a lot of damage. Or gets a shield, I don't know, we have to see here. We gonna get a shield, and we get the defense drop, which is really nice, and we can just farm, and my opponent goes into an S-Calf, and we have the Mandibuzz. The Mandibuzz is pretty decent against an S-Calf, and we are in a pretty okay spot, but not the best either, because the Nidoqueen can still go for an Earth Power against our Empoleon, and basically have to call that. We can go for the foul play here. I think my opponent does not shield. I would like him to shield, but he doesn't. And what we have to do now is call the bait, or like if we're not baiting, we have to shield. I'm just gonna call the bait, and I was correct there. I can farm down. If you're in trap power, you would have won. I think he had like enough energy to even with like close to two. What about that again? I see a grass type lead, and now we have Reggie still in the back. Like if we would run one fire type, this team was already dead. But then Sirwine, like why? This guy's actually even on my friend list. And I think there is, we would have easily won this game at the end if we would get to the next foul play here. And you're gonna see, like it looked in my position like I should have got there. Yeah, I think like, I don't know. But in my position it looked like I would have got there, but I guess my opponent just sniped with a one lock on there, which was very crucial as we had to shield here now, and we are in a really bad spot now. And yeah, that's not looking too good. But it's a hard counter team in general, as you're gonna see with the Golbat coming into us Charmer. Actually, I thought of surrendering here, then I thought, this Charm still does a lot of damage. Like, I already have him at half-half. He has to shield here. Maybe there's still some possibility that you win this, and we can try it at least. I think I would easily already would have won this if I still had my one shield from the Reggie steal, but hey, it's fine. And we can go for two drill packs here. And we have like still some health left. And can we survive another wing attack so we can get our waterfall through? We cannot because of the debuff and my pawn wants not the 1 HP in the dream. Very sad. Like on my position in normal time, this is sped up by 2.5 times. The minibus matchup looked like I just missed out through lag or something of the foul play. Like I had the foul play for a long time on the bottom, which of course most of the time when I talk about lag and what I had in my games, if I speed up the battles, of course it doesn't really look like that. It just like always happens. And yeah, here against Registeel again. I don't know, a lot of people like Registeel is difficult with the team, is still doable with the Emporion at least, and also with the Granbull. Granbull also has a lot of fun against Registeel sometimes, if you get enough, if he has like no shields and if he can get to a close combat, just completely destroys the thing. My opponent goes into Machamp, I can, like, it doesn't really matter if I hit this, I would have KO'd him anyway, and he has a Victini in the back. This is my team again, wasn't it? Yeah, I think that was my Victini team. And now I'm gonna lose against my Victini team. Because my opponent just barely gets to the move, I get my move even through, but this Crush Stop going KO us and he has 1 HP in Dream. Good game there, at least he is someone who definitely watches me, so... Hello. Here you are on the video. Next up, we have a Hitmon top against us. Actually, I think I went with this team, by the way, I didn't say that yet. 11-4? I think 11-4 today. I don't know how I went in the previous day. I think I played for two full sets and like for half of a set. So I don't know how well it went there. But today I went 4-1, 4-1 and 3-2 with this team. So I cannot really complain. There were like some games which I should have won as well. So it is fine. Here we get two shields against this Frostless. And Frostless throws against us again. And I don't know. I guess it has Crunch and Shadow Ball. Because I have no idea why he always goes for Crunch here. I'm just gonna let this go, it's another Crunch, like don't run Crunch on Frostless. I don't see the play for Crunch Frostless, to be honest. It is funny, but here we have a Dark-type, but also a Poison-type. We don't care, we just charm him down. It's gonna be a good game already, because, you know, like Drapion, we don't care about this thing. We have our Granbull, charms to Broken. And we can go Focus Combat here, and this is gonna KO this Hitmontop. Next up, we're gonna have Alola. Actually, it's something that I don't really like to see. I face that thing a lot, maybe I should also play that. I heard it's like really good. So maybe I should. And yeah, I think this matchup is decent. I think I always win two shields with the Emporion. Even on the one shield, maybe. But we have to shield one Hydro Pump because it hurts. The opponent goes into an S-Cav, which is fine for me. But yeah. Molar is really, really cool. I really want one for Ultra League. I have now a 13, 15, 15 shiny lucky, which I can power up. Maybe I do that. I have a lot of XL candy, actually. Let me see real quick. I have around 180 or something. So I don't need that much. So maybe I can showcase that a bit. It won't be fully XL, most likely, when I have it for Ultra League. But maybe I power that up, like, now. Enough power up quest. Before I used to power up my, what's it called, my Ferrothorn, and my Ferrothorn is now done for Ultra League. It went perfectly to 2500, so I can get something else to power up. I guess it's gonna be this thing or my rank 1 Shadow Skorupi for Ultra League, or then like Drapion when he evolved, which is also really cool. Here we have a Lapras, and Lapras is also pretty tricky, but with Emporion, I think the matchup is way better here than in Great League, Ultra League, because Lapras is way more bulk in Ultra League than in Great League. We can go for some drill packs and we don't really care. Also, if you are watching right now, last time, I think the Malamar video, I said like half asleep in the end that everybody who is watching at that part should say hello in the comments. Now, please say your favorite fruit in the comments. Just tell something completely funny and random. Just your favorite fruit. Thanks. And here we can just destroy this Machamp. Next up, we're gonna have Emporion against Ninetales. Very interesting. We have a Manabus switch in, which I like. And yeah, Manabus, I think we're... Air Slash is even better for me. I don't know why you went for the foul play there. Don't ask me, like, why do you not go for the Air Ace? Maybe you run Shadow Ball. That doesn't make sense. We can go for close combat here, and we already nearly KO the 90s, and we can farm him down here, so good game there. We can go for a beautiful draw back here now against this victory bell, and he gonna surrender because we had a perfect counter team for my opponent. You already see, by the way, at the bottom, like, my elo going up with this team. I think now I'm at 2251. I don't know how mixed up my battles are right now. Instead, like, I just put them into my editing software and doesn't really, I don't know the pattern how they choose that, but like, it's always kind of mixed up. But yeah, right now I'm like around 2300 again. It was there already before, as you saw in like my Victini video. I tanked one day on purpose with only Pokemon below rank 100 on P Pokemon my whole team, which was hilarious. I had like some really cool wins with Piloswine and stuff like this. But still, of course, tanked a bit because you cannot really play that good with like completely garbage Pokemon. So it was a lot of fun to play. But yeah, now I'm kinda want to get to the next rank slowly. I mean, the best people are like at 2600 right now. As I said before already, I'm not looking for any. Oh, look at this, by the way. Ah, oh, this is so beautiful. It is so beautiful. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I'm not really looking for the leaderboards right now. It's just like, I don't know. I can go back to grinding leaderboards, anything like this, if people are interested. Even with fun teams, if fast move denial and stuff like this is fixed. Right now, if you look at like a lot of them are streamers and they're like really good battler, but if you see how they play, they basically always deny every quick move from your opponent, and it's just like I cannot do that here. But I don't know if it's like phone, internet connection, location, whatever. Like, I cannot do that here. So I always try to give my opponents the least amount of turns I have to give them, but they just go straight for the basically same tie, and they just don't get any quick move in there against them, but always get their quick move in and basically get 15 plus turns every game for free, which is just such an advantage, and I cannot do that here. It's not blaming them or anything. I blame Niantic for not having a game that works. But yeah, I would just wish that the game would be a bit more consistent and working well for everybody the same way, and not like that somebody with, I don't know, if it's better phone, if it's better connection, if it's like the location to, you know, Niantic server or whatever it is, have like an advantage there. It just has to be consistent, and then we can talk about a game that with good servers might be even like esports compatible. But right now it is very far away from that because servers are trash. The inconsistency of getting fast moves in is like really bad, and having like lag spikes and everything around is just not cool. Here we have Obstagoon against us again, which is decent for the air slash one. That's why I also kind of want to use air slash on my Bandibus. I want to have two answers in the back that can deal with fighting types. With the Snarl version, you don't really have the option, to be honest. So going for an area ace here, putting him low, and Wormadam. And this was like one of the worst things I could have faced. So I have to swap out into my Empoleon, and it does not look too good. I have to try to get him low enough. He goes for a Bug Buzz, which is cool. I can go for a charge move there. I don't know if I can farm down though. It definitely comes down to the wire. He has to throw against me, which is good. But still, I have to go for two more on here. And can I farm down? I can farm down in time. And even steel types, we don't really care about with our Granbull. Granbull just chunks through everything. Like, honestly, if you haven't built a Shadow Granbull, I think it's one of the best charmers in the meta. I would rather use that. Especially, like, the good thing about Granbull in this meta is that you have less bulky steel types. So, unlike, for example, Ninetales, which has the coverage for Grigifers, which you don't see either of them, you have the option here with the Granbull in general to just go through stuff because you don't have the same book as you have in other in other leagues. So having Shadow Granbull here is, I think, way better than having Shadow Granbull in the other league. And you see here I'm getting Blizzard by this fish. I didn't even know that the thing can learn Blizzard. And yeah, it's just completely destroyed me. But what we also destroyed me, you're gonna see now, I get the defense drop and a crit move in on the CMP tie. Yeah, talk about esport. Beautiful game. I just love this game. Into the last game. Oh, Empoleon against Machamp. Oh, we're looking really good. Wow, we are love to see it. And we're gonna get baited. Wow, we can go for an aerial ace here. At least get the shield back. And the cool thing about the Amanda boss now, we can still survive this. And here we're gonna survive the Rockside easily. We can go for another aerial ace and gonna put him low. Or KO him. And he goes into Hypno, which is kinda bad for me because I don't really have shields anymore. And we have to see what he has in back now because it all depends on that. If we can do something there, we have to go for a charge move now. He can go for another Thunder Punch. And now we have to swap out because we're already too low. And now it depends on what he has in the back. And that's going to be it for this video. Thanks all for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day. And we're going to lose.